Praise the Lord. Today, I said today, your mountain will roll away in Jesus' name. Even if God has to do it one stone at a time, it's going. What are you? My mountain is going. The Lord will touch you miraculously tonight in Jesus' name. There's a mighty connection coming upon your life right now. And wherever you are here, or you're over there in your district, or in your region, or in your state, or in any nation, or you are connected online, connection for you today. Power connection. Supernatural connection. Today is that day. Your mountain is going. My mountain is going. Father, we thank you tonight. We bless your name. We know that there is no time to waste. Lord, instantaneously, supernaturally, and immediately we mention that great name, the name Jesus. Mountains will roll away in Jesus' name. I pray that nobody will be disconnected. Everyone here, everyone over there, everyone everywhere, connection tonight. Supernatural connection tonight. And you touch everyone and you give us miracles that are definite, salvation definite, healing definite, deliverance definite. And Lord, we pray a spectacular touch for everyone tonight. Confirm it in every life. In Jesus' name we pray.
For instantaneous miracle.
Father, amen. For instantaneous miracle.
We are coming to the word of God, and tonight there's going to be a supernatural touch in the divine connection. When we talk of connection, natural is connection with God, is connection with your Savior, connection with your healer, connection with your deliverer. Connection comes upon your life tonight, and a miracle, an explosion will take place in your heart. We're looking at Genesis chapter 32, and I'm reading from verse 24. Genesis chapter 32, and we're reading from verse 24. And Jacob,
was left alone, and there wrestled a man with him until the breaking of the day. And then in verse 25, and when he saw that he prevailed not against him, he touched. That's what is going to happen tonight. I said that's what is happening tonight. He touched the hollow of his thigh, and the hollow of Jacob's thigh was out of joint as he wrestled with him. And then in verse 26 it says, and he said, let me go, for the day breaketh. And he said, I will not let you go except you bless me. You didn't say that for yourself. I will not let thee go except thou bless me. You came from heaven, you have connected with me, and you are touching me, and I need the blessing after the touch, and you will not go back to heaven unless you drop a miracle in my life. If that's what you are saying tonight, that's what will happen. If that is what you expect tonight, that is what will happen. I will not let you go. We're not leaving here except you bless me. Blessing of salvation in Jesus' name. Blessing of healing in Jesus' name. And blessing of deliverance in your life in Jesus' name. That spectacular thing you need, and you came, and you have been thinking about it, you have been praying about it. Tonight is that night. And the Lord will not leave you until that thing is done. Look at verse 27. It says, and he said unto him, what is thy name? The Lord will talk to you personally. He will recognize your name personally. He will recognize your problem and all the things that are covered and all the things you have been battling with. In the case of Jacob, he's been battling with this for about 20 years. And that night when God sent the angel and the angel touched him, 20 years problem rolled away. 20 years problem in your life rolling away tonight. 30 years problem in your life rolling away tonight. And how long it might have been, that mountain has been there, and people tell you adjust and just live with that mountain. There's nothing you can do. Maybe there's nothing you can do, but God can do something. And God will do that thing. 40 years a mountain will move away tonight in Jesus' name. What is thy name? What is your problem? What is your challenge? What are you going through? And he said, Jacob. He didn't talk much. All he wanted and all he was looking for is, I want a miracle tonight. Tonight, you are not talking much. Tonight, you are not, talking to another person. What did they say? What reference did they quote? And what is going on there? What do you see over there? You are not talking with anybody. You are face to face with the miracle worker tonight in Jesus' name. And then in verse 28, it says, and he said, thy name shall be called no more Jacob. It will change your name. It will change your nature. It will change your personality. It will change everything that has been traumatic in your life, problematic in your life, anything that has bowed you down, anything you've been wondering, how do I go through life with this? Tonight, tonight. Somebody help me shout tonight. All those things that had bothered you, everything will vanish away. People will see you tomorrow, they will not recognize you. They will see you next week, they will not recognize you. Because of what is happening tonight in your life. And then it says, thy name is no more Jacob, but Israel. For as a prince, you are not a pauper anymore. And you are not an orphan anymore. As a prince, thou hast power with God and with men, and hast prevailed. I have prevailed. I have overcome. Because of the power of God and because of the instantaneous miracle the Lord is going to do in your life, you have power with God. Give me a good amen. You have power with men, no matter what that man, who that man is. You have power with all men. And tonight, you prevail in Jesus' name. Tonight, we are talking on the subject of the supernatural touch in divine connection. The supernatural touch in divine connection. Three things we're looking at. Number one, the heart transforming touch. You see, the Lord is going to touch you from the inside to the outside. He's going to touch every part of you. There's going to be a miracle of recreation in your life today. I said, a miracle of recreation in your life today. Everything that is bad will become good. Everything that is rotten will come alive. Everything that is dark will be brightened tonight. Everything that bows you down, everything that it appears from your inner man and from your heart, it's like the problem is there. And because of that, out of the heart comes all the issues of life. And since the heart is bad, what do you think? Every other thing will be bad. But point number one tonight, the heart transforming touch. Are you there? It's for you. Say, it's for me. Number two, the healing transcending touch. The transcending touch. That is, whatever the problem, whatever the sickness, whatever the infirmity, and whatever the disease may be, there is a transcending touch. It will reach you at the point of that sickness. You are healed tonight in Jesus' name. Number three is the heavenly transfiguring touch. Transfiguring touch. Let me break that word down for you. Transfigure. Figure. You have a figure. That figure is weak. that weak figure is oppressed, that figure is downtrodden, and then there is a trance, there is a translation, there is a change, and there is a mighty transfiguring tonight. The Lord will take you to the Mount of Transfiguration as we are praying. By the time we open our eyes, you are a different man. You are a different woman. Because of that heavenly transfiguring touch that is coming upon your life tonight, in Jesus' name. Tonight, there is no go and come. Tonight, there is no maybe or perhaps. Tonight, that touch will come to you directly, and it will transform, it will transcend, and it will transfigure everything in your life, even tonight, in Jesus' name. I rejoice with you already. You have a testimony. I said I rejoice with you already. You have a testimony. I have a testimony. I have a testimony. And it's not going to be like, you know, a little testimony. I had, rashes on my cheek, and then God has transformed me. That's good. But the testimony we have tonight, and the one that is going to come out of your mouth, look at this big mountain in your life. It is rolled away in Jesus' name. Let's look at number one. Number one, the heart transforming touch. The heart transforming touch. We're looking at 1 Samuel chapter 10, verse 26. Here was a man, his name Saul, and he had lost 3 asses. He was looking for asses. Pay attention. The Lord gave him a throne. I said he was looking for asses, and the Lord gave him a throne. Compare 3 asses with being the king of the whole of Israel, of a nation. The gap is wide. What you are looking for, what you are searching for, that's a small thing. God is going to multiply that tenfold, 20-fold, 100-fold, and the Lord will surprise you with a miracle. Look at this in 1 Samuel chapter 10, verse 26. And Saul also went home to Gibeah, and there went with him a band of men whose hearts God had touched. Whose hearts God had touched. Do you know God touches people's hearts? And as you are there tonight, it will touch and transform. I said it will touch and transform. It will so change you in the inner man, and so change your heart, and so change your mind. Everything that had been weak and powerless before, everything will be powerful and mighty tonight, even in your heart, in Jesus' name. Understand, a bunch of men, not just Saul alone, and not just one person, 2 people, 3 people, a bunch of men. Many of them, as they came, the Lord touched their hearts. And as you have come tonight, anywhere you are, I said as you have come tonight, a transforming touch in your heart. I said a transforming touch in your life. It will happen. The moment you come to God and say, God, here I am, I need a touch, a divine touch in my heart, a divine touch in my inner man. I've not been able to walk straight, I've not been able to live straight because of the condition of my heart, but I want to live straight, and I want to live a positive life and a powerful life. And the Lord said, all right, I'll do it for you now. What is the person I'm talking about? He will do it for you now. And then he will touch that heart, and you are never the same again. Actually, even now, he has started the work in your heart. I said he has started the work in your heart. And when we finish the message, and we say, if you want to give that heart to the Lord Jesus Christ, for him to touch, for him to transform, just raising up your hand, the work is done. The transformation is done. And a real heart, and a beautiful heart, and a heavenly heart, the Lord will give to you tonight in Jesus' name. Look at this in Ezekiel chapter 36. Ezekiel chapter 36, I'm reading from verse 25. He said, then will I sprinkle clean water upon you. God said he himself will do this one. He will not even delegate it to an angel like he did for Jacob himself. By his own power, himself, by his own redemption, himself, by his own mighty power, it will wash you tonight. It will cleanse your heart tonight in Jesus' name. Then will I sprinkle clean water upon you, and ye shall be clean. And ye shall be clean. If God washes anything, that thing will be clean. If God cleanses any heart, that heart will be clean. If your heart, no matter how you have been out of control, you couldn't control your heart, you couldn't control your mind, you couldn't control your personality. But then God says, don't worry, control has come. Cleansing has come. Because he himself will touch you, and he says, ye shall be clean, and from all your filthiness and from all your idols will I cleanse you. Look at verse 27. It says, 26 rather, verse 26, in your heart also will I give you. Are you waiting for that? Are you expecting that? I said, are you expecting that? Expectation, manifestation. Expectation, realization. It will happen. You'll be surprised. The Lord will give you a new heart tonight in Jesus' name. You know, the heart that is always down, the heart that is now upright will be given to you. The heart that is always discouraged, I don't know what I will do again, I don't know where I will go again, God will give you a heart that has boldness and courage, and you will face the future, and what God has created you for, your heart will move you on, move you on. You will reach there in Jesus' name. A new heart also will I give you. And a new spirit will I put within you. And I will take away the stony heart that makes us stumble, the stony heart that is hard, the stony heart that is not changing, the stony heart, no matter how many surfaces stony heart, attest, the stone is always a stone, but a stone is going away today. You remember, God will move my mountain. I said, God will move my mountain. If he has to do it a stone at a time, he will do it. I rejoice with you. You are in the right place tonight. And you are in the right mood tonight. Because just now is going to remove that stone. And in your heart, he will give you. He says, he will give you an heart of flesh. It will give you an heart of flesh. Are you there tonight? I said tonight, God cannot fail, and God has never failed. In your case, it will not fail tonight. But now look at Proverbs chapter 23, and I'm reading from verse 26. Proverbs chapter 23, I was looking at verse 26. My son, give me thine heart. I want to walk on that heart. Give me thine heart. I want to cleanse that heart. Give me thine heart. I want to transform that heart. Give me thine heart. And I want to make a permanent change so that that mind and that heart will be clean, will be pure. That heart will be positive, and that heart will be so encouraged and bold, and will be able to achieve anything and everything. And all you have to do is surrender that heart to the Lord. My son, give me thine heart, and let thine eyes observe my ways. And then once you give him your heart and you hand it over to him, the rest is for God to do. And it's tonight. I said it's tonight. He will do that miracle of transformation in your heart tonight in Jesus' name. Guilt will go away. Grace will come into your heart. condemnation will go away. I say condemnation will go away. And the joy of the salvation of the Lord will occupy your heart tonight in Jesus' name. We're coming to point number two now. Point number two is the transcending touch, the healing transcending touch. Healing. Somebody help me shout, healing. If you have never seen healing before, you'll see it tonight. If you have never seen, I mean spectacular healing. I mean supernatural healing. I mean a kind of healing that nobody can ever doubt. They will see it in your life and they'll see it in your body. The Lord is going to give you a transcending touch that will heal you tonight and heal you perfectly and heal you permanently, and that thing will never come back again. We're coming to in Matthew chapter 8, and we're reading from verse 1. Matthew chapter 8, and we're reading from verse 1. When he was come down from the mountain, great multitudes followed him. Look at verse 2. And behold, there came a leper and worshipped him, saying, Lord, if thou wilt, thou canst make me clean. And look at what the leper said. If thou wilt, he wasn't sure of the willingness of God. He wasn't sure of the willingness of Christ. He thought he was far behind the line. He thought as a leper, he was not allowed to mix with the congregation. He was like a person that he didn't know any promise of God. He didn't know any performance that will come his way. And he said, here am I, I'm an outcast. Here am I, I don't know whether you're willing or not. If thou be willing, thou canst make me clean. I know you can, only I'm not sure you're willing. But we are sure God is willing. I said, I am sure that God is willing. Why am I sure? Because he said, I am the Lord that healeth thee. That's why we're sure that he's willing. Why are we sure? He said, call upon me and I will answer you. And I will show you great things that you have never known. That's why we know he's willing. Why are we sure that he's willing? By his stripes, I am healed. And since he has suffered for us, and he took our sickness away, he took our infirmity away, and he took all our disease away, bless the Lord, oh my soul, bless the Lord, all that you see within me, who forgiveth all thine iniquities. All your iniquities will be forgiven tonight. And then that healeth, who healeth all thine infirmities, and then it will renew your yoke like that of the eagle. Because of that, I don't come like the leper. I said you don't come like the leper. You come like with the promise of God. Ask, it shall be given unto you. I'm talking about you there. Seek, and ye shall find. I'm talking about somebody there. And knock, and the door shall be open to you tonight. Hear this, hear this, hear this. Everyone that asketh receiveth. He that seeketh findeth, and to him that knocketh, it shall be. So we're not like the leper that is coming with fear and coming with doubt and coming with slight unbelief, saying, if thou wilt, thou canst make me clean. The Lord is willing. Look at verse 3. Look at verse 3. Jesus put forth his hand and touched him. And touched him, somebody there, and touched him, he will touch you. I said, he will touch you, saying, I will. That forever settles the question. He said, I will. Tonight, Jesus Christ, the same yesterday and today and forever, he said, I will at that time. He's saying, I will now to you. Is no respecter of persons. He said, I will to that leper. And he's saying, I will to you. Maybe your own is not leprosy. If it is brain problem, all that is cleared away tonight. If it is goiter, all that is cleared away tonight. And if it is cancer,
praise the Lord, that cancer will not be stronger than the name of Jesus in your life. The name of Jesus will roll that cancer away tonight in Jesus' name. If it is something you have been battling with, you've gone to the hospital and the hospital said, Mr. Man or Madam, this one is beyond us. It is not beyond God. I said it is not beyond God. The Lord who has healed the leper, who cleansed the leper, who was not even sure, and his prayer was full of doubt, yet the Lord healed him tonight. We're praying a prayer of faith, a prayer of power, a prayer that is able to move every mountain away in your life. And as we pray that prayer tonight, miracle, healing, deliverance, the spectacular will happen in your life tonight in Jesus' name. I will be thou clean. Look at this, and immediately. Help me pronounce that word. Say it, say it, say it. Immediately. When is your miracle? I say, when is your miracle? Immediately, instantaneously, at this very time, as we mentioned the name of Jesus, that name above every name, that name above every name of sickness, the Lord will roll that thing away tonight in Jesus' name. And immediately, his leprosy was cleansed. Immediately, his leprosy was cleansed. Look at Mark chapter 5, verse 25. Mark chapter 5, we're reading from verse 25. And a certain woman which had an issue of blood 12 years. Don't worry about how many years, 12 years, 20 years, 30 years. It's still the same. And whatever, however long that infirmity or that sickness or that disease might have been, and whatever the cause in your life, whatever brought it to your life, don't worry about that. Number of years, don't worry about that. A single touch will take everything away. It says, a certain woman which had an issue of blood 12 years, then in verse 26, and had suffered many things of many physicians. She had gone to different places where she expected healing and had spent all that she had and was nothing bettered, but rather grew worse. Nothing bettered, but rather grew worse. But you know what I appreciate about the woman? The woman did not say, this shameful disease is taking a long time. Let me end it up. There are many people, before their daybreak and before the time of their breakthrough, they get discouraged and then they end it up. You will not end it up. Where there's hope, there's life. Where there's hope, there'll be healing. Where there's faith, there'll be miracle. And so, don't end up anything. Your life is in the hands of the Lord. No matter how the problem has remained, how long it has been, today, solution has now come. I said, solution has now come. And look at verse 27. In verse 27, she said, when she heard of Jesus. Have you heard about Jesus? I said, have you heard of Jesus? In all these testimonies we heard, we heard of Jesus. In all these messages were given, we heard of Jesus. In the healing of the leper, we heard of Jesus. And we've heard that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. She heard, and you have heard. What you have heard will bear fruit in your life. What you have heard will bring healing in your life. What you have heard will bring a spectacular, spontaneous miracle in your life tonight in Jesus' name. When she heard of Jesus, came in the press behind and touched his garment. And touched his garment. He touches you when you touch him. And tonight, as you touch him by faith, and you know he died for me. He took my sin away. He took my sicknesses away. And by faith, I touch him tonight. From heaven, he will touch you. In verse 28, it says, for she said, if I may but touch his clothes, I shall be whole. I shall be whole. She was coming, and every step of the way, I shall be whole. And every time when, you know, this sin has been there for 12 years, don't worry, I shall be whole. And then they said somebody else had this kind of problem and never got over it. For me, I shall be whole. Somebody there, I shall be whole. A man there, I shall be whole. A woman there, tell me, I shall be whole. Every one of us tonight, we'll be whole in Jesus' name. Look at verse 29. In verse 29, and straightway, that's the word again. That means immediately. That means instantaneously. And straightway, the fountain of her blood was dried up. Dried up. All the fountain of the devil in your life, dried up. All the fountain of disease, dried up. All the fountain of infirmity, dried up. All the thing that is so deep and so wide that nobody can treat and nobody can cross, dried up tonight in Jesus' name. And she felt in her body that she was healed of that plague. 12 years of shame, all gone. 12 years of suffering, all gone. 12 years of sickness, all gone. It's gone tonight. To the sea of God's forgetfulness, all your problems are gone tonight in Jesus' name. Look at chapter 7, Mark chapter 7, and I'm reading from verse 32. Mark chapter 7, we're reading from verse 32. It says, and they bring unto him one that was dead, and had an impediment in his speech, and they beseech him to put his hand upon him. Look at verse 33. In verse 33, and he took him aside from the multitude and put his fingers into his ears and speech and touched his tongue. And touched his tongue. Have you noticed all these references I'm reading to you? They brought this one, he touched him. And they brought this other one, she touched him. And as they were touching and touching, every touch had a transcendent miracle and healing came. And as the touching is coming to you tonight, your miracle has come. And then look at verse 34. It says, and looking up to heaven, he sighed and says unto him, Ephphatha, that is, be opened. Not a long prayer, not a long sentence, be opened. And when you hear that tonight, short and straightforward prayer, that miracle will touch you right there. And then in verse 35, and straightway, that's the word again. That word is in the territory of the Lord Jesus Christ. Immediately, instantaneously, straightway, his ears were open. And the string of his tongue was loosed, and he spake plain. If you're deaf and dumb, you will hear, you'll speak tonight. If your bones are broken, those bones are joined together instantaneously today. As we mentioned the name of Jesus, and a touch comes to you in Jesus' name. Look at verse 37. 37, and they were beyond measure astonished. Some of them, they didn't know what to do, whether to clap, whether to shout, whether to laugh, whether to jump, whether to dance or whatever, because they were beyond measure astonished, saying, he has done all things well. He has done all things well.
I'm talking about you. He has done all things well. I'm talking about your wife. He has done all things well. I'm talking about your husband. He has done all things well. I'm talking about that person in the hospital, and your mind is with that person in the hospital. He has done all things well. I'm talking about your child. That child, since you gave birth to the child, 3 years now, 4 years now, the child cannot stand up and walk. But Christ tonight has done all things well. Children will receive miracle. Young people will receive miracle. Papas and mamas will receive miracle. And newcomers will receive miracle. Everyone here tonight, no exception. Anyone over there tonight, it is Jesus. And Jesus is able, and he has done all things well. What are you? All things well. All things well, because he maketh both the dead to hear and the dumb to speak. It will happen. It is happening already. Look at number three. We're looking at number three here, and this is the heavenly transfiguring touch. Heavenly transfiguring touch. As the Lord touches you tonight, people will not even recognize that you're still the same problem. Because many years of problems, and the Lord touches you tonight, it will roll away everything. 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 He will do it in Jesus' name. Let's come back to the story of Jacob. It says in Genesis chapter 32. Genesis 32. And I'm reading from verse 24. And Jacob was left alone. And there wrestled a man with him until the breaking of the day. Wrestling, wrestling, wrestling until the breaking of the day. And then in verse 25, and when he saw that he prevailed not against him, he touched the hollow of his thigh. And the hollow of Jacob's thigh was out of joint as he wrestled with him. Wrestling, you know, there are people, they wrestle and wrestle in prayer, but the blessing has not come, and they are happy to say, you know, I can stay there for 6 hours and wrestle in prayer. Well, that's good, but you know what you need beyond that wrestling is faith. The faith that takes, the faith that touches, the faith that transforms, the faith that empowers, and the faith that transfigures you. Wrestling, wrestling, wrestling is not enough. It's the power of faith to walk in your life. You know, some people say, I pray for 5 days for salvation and I wrestle and wrestle. Maybe that's all right, but are you saved? Being saved is what's important, and salvation is very simple. You don't have to go 5 days, 7 days, and 14 days before salvation comes. Whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Right here, right there, instantaneous salvation will come to you in Jesus' name. And then it says, the hollow of the thigh went out of joint as he wrestled with him. Look at verse 26. In verse 26, and he said, let me go. That's where some people stop. After they have wrestled and wrestled and wrestled, no salvation, no healing. They just sweat and sweat and sweat in praying. Let me go. They said, okay, I'll come back tomorrow. You are not like that. I said, you are not like that. Tomorrow a greater thing will happen, but today you have an immediate salvation today, an immediate forgiveness here today, an immediate conversion here today, an immediate transformation that transcends anything you have ever known. It is here today. I will get. See how you are saying it as if you are not sure. It says, let me go, for the day breaketh. And he said, I, Jacob, I, what's your name? I, what's your name? I, so and so, will not let you go. That blessing you brought from heaven, you must give me tonight. That blessing you brought from God, you must give me tonight. That miracle, that supernatural touch and that transcending touch and that transfiguring touch and that change that comes from heaven. I must have it tonight. Let me go. No, you cannot go, because you will not go except you bless me. Except you bless me. The Lord loves the people that know what they're looking for, and they know they're going to get it, and there's no shadow of doubt in their heart, and they say, tonight is my night. I will have. You will have. I said you will have. And then in verse 27 it says, and he said unto him, what's thy name? Well, in the past your name sinner, but now your name is going to change. He'll call you a sage. I said he'll call you a sage. You know, some people, they say Saint Peter, meet you sage. They say Saint Paul, meet you sage. They say Saint Mary, meet you sage. Me, I said me. It will change your name today. No more guilt, no more condemnation, no more bondage. Freedom, freedom, freedom. You're free tonight in Jesus' name. Look at verse 28. And he said, thy name shall be no more called Jacob, but Israel. And I prophesy into your life tonight, your name shall no more be called sinner, but saint. And I'm pronouncing the word of God upon your life tonight. Your life will no more be called failure, but success. I pronounce it upon your life tonight. Your name is no more Mr. Mrs. Downtrodden, but your name becomes the man on the mountaintop, the woman on the mountaintop. For as a prince, look at that, look at that. When you stand up tonight, after the Lord has changed you and transformed you, then you stand up as a prince. I'm talking to somebody. As a prince, as a prince. It says, as a prince, as thou power with God. Power with God. There is a connection now. Jesus is making the connection on your behalf, and you have power with God, and you have power with men. And no man will walk over you. No man will stand in your way. No man will disorganize your life, and no man will ruin your life anymore. The moment you give your life to the Lord Jesus Christ and you say, here is my heart, here is my life, I offer everything to you, he will take you and mold you and remold you, and then there's connection. I said there's connection. And then you have power with God. Anything you ask God, because you have power with God, he will answer you. And you have power with men. All the people, all the places you have been going, you ask for this, they say no. You ask for that, they say no. And you say, hey, nobody ever says yes to me. But you know, tonight, you have power with men. They will say yes to you. I said they will say yes to you. And thou hast prevailed. Thou hast overcome. Thou hast conquered. Anybody there that claims this, why don't you stand up? Why don't you stand up and know that tonight is a special night in your life? Tonight is a glorious night in your life. You will prevail. You will conquer. You will overcome. There is nothing. Nothing from hell, nothing from the sea, nothing from the forest, nothing from land can disturb you tonight, can hinder you tonight. You will prevail tonight. Open your mouth and talk to the Lord and say, Lord, I present my heart to you. I present my life unto you. I present the past. And no matter how dirty that life has been, and no matter how destroyed that life had been, how conquered that life had been, how sick that life had been, my son, give me your heart. My daughter, give me your heart. You give him your heart tonight, and then forgiveness will come. Freedom will come. You will prevail. Power will come. And then you'll be given the power to become a child of God, a son of God, a daughter of God. It's there. It's there. It's there. Christ is very close to you. It's your Savior. It's your Redeemer. Christ is very close to you. He will turn your heart around. He will change your heart. He will transform your heart. And tonight, the Spirit of God will bear witness. Your sins are forgiven. And all the load, all the guilt, all the condemnation of sin, they're totally taken away. Amen. Let the church say. Now we're making the connection. Are you ready? I said we're making the connection. Are you ready? He wants to clean up that heart. He wants to forgive all your sins. He wants to change. He wants to transform. He wants to take the old life away, the old heart away, and he wants to give you a new heart. And it's just for the asking. You don't have to wait and wait and wait. It's yours for the asking. If you ask, he'll give you. You seek, you'll find. You knock, it will be opened unto you. Heads bowed and eyes closed. You're giving your heart to the Lord Jesus Christ right now. He'll wash you. He'll cleanse you. He'll forgive you. He'll transform that heart. If you're giving your heart to the Lord right now, for him to make a transforming touch, just raise up that hand. God bless you there. Just raise up that hand. God bless you there. God bless you. Thank you. Thank you. Raise up that hand. Raise up that hand. He's going to do it immediately. He's going to do it instantaneously. He's going to do it right now. The moment you call upon him, whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Make up your mind. Make up your mind. Turn away from your sin. Say, Lord, I'm sorry for the past. I'm sorry for my disappointing you. Lord, I come now. I come now. That's why I'm raising up my hand. Forgive me. He will. He will. He will immediately. God bless you for raising up the hand. Tell him now, Lord, I belong to you now. Only you, I belong to you alone. I don't belong to Satan anymore. I don't belong to evildoers anymore. I belong to you completely. Transform my heart. Change my heart. Give salvation to my heart. Thank him that he has done it. He never rejects anyone that calls upon him sincerely. Tell him, I thank you, Lord. I've asked. I've received. And I know that you've done it. I'll pray with you now. Father, in Jesus' name, all these who have offered, surrendered, and given their hearts to you, oh Lord, forgive them in Jesus' name. According to your promise, take all their sins away and put all their sins in the sea of God's forgetfulness, never to be remembered against them anymore in Jesus' name. Take their guilt away. Take their condemnation away. And take their weakness away. And I pray, Lord, definite forgiveness, you grant them now. Freedom from sin, you grant unto them right now. Let your grace come into their lives and make them new men, new women, new boys and new girls, having the salvation of the Lord in their hearts right now in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, because I know it's done. I know it's done. We believe it's done. In Jesus' name, we pray. Praise the Lord, he has done it. I said, praise the Lord, he has done it. He has taken those your sins away. He has forgiven you. He has given you freedom. And you will never be the same again. our counselors are there. They'll give you the slip to fill in all the information so that we can follow up on you later and see how to be of help to you more and more. State Pastor will come now and lead us in this section. And now after that, immediate healing, miracle, deliverance, dominion in your life, in Jesus' name. Amen.